they were to read out of Genesis 21, verses 9 through 15. And Sarah saw the son of Abraham, the Egyptian man she had born unto Abraham, Michael. Wherefore she said unto Abraham, cast out this handmaid and her son, for the son of this handmaid shall not be here with my son, even with Isaac. And the thing was very rigorous in Abraham's sight on account of his son. And God said unto Abraham, let it not be rigorous in the sight of the land, and because of thy handmaid, and all that Sarah had unto thee, hearken unto her. For in Isaac shall the seed be called. And also, Lord, the son of the handmaid, will I make a nation, because he is thy seed. And Abraham rose up early in the morning, and took bread and a bottle. Bread and a bottle of water, and gave it unto Hagar, put it on her shoulder, and gave her a child, and sent her away. And she departed and wandered in the wilderness of Beersheba. And the water in the bottle was spent, and she cast the child under one of the shrubs. That's our verse, Genesis 21, verses 9 through 15.
Come on, let's give God a hand clap of praise this morning. If you came to bless his name, come on, let me hear you. Let me see if you know God has been good to you. If he brought you over this week, because it could have been the other way. Now, if you could this morning, will you help us lift up the name of the faith? Come on, put those hands together. Come on, put those hands together. You come to bless, come on. Magnify the Lord.
Magnify the Lord with me.
Come on, whom the Son he hath redeemed.
The Son he hath redeemed.
Come on, clap your hands.
Everything. My Lord of everything.
Come on. I will
bless the Lord.
Come on, bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord.
This morning, let me see you clap your hands.
Bless the Lord at all times.
I will.
I will bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord at all times.
Come on, bless.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul and all that's within me. Bless his name.
Oh, come on, come on, come on, come on. Put those hands together. Say, bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul and all.
Oh, come on, stay right there. I don't think they got it. I don't think they got it. Bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord. Oh, my soul and all that's within me. Bless his name.
Come on, if you can't help us bless his name, let me see you put those hands together. Bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord. Oh, my soul and all that's within me. Bless his name.
Let's go out. When I'm lost and all alone,
I will bless the Lord.
I will bless the Lord.
I will bless
Come
the Lord.
On, if you came this morning to bless
I
the Lord,
bless the
let
Lord.
Me see you put your hand together.
I will bless the Lord.
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 He's been good to me.
I will bless the Lord.
I'll bless his name.
I will bless the
every
Lord.
Every chance I get.
I will bless the Lord.
I will bless the Lord.
I will bless the Lord.
He brought me out.
I will bless the Lord.
From a world of sin.
I will bless the Lord.
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 On Monday, Tuesday.
I will bless the Lord.
On Wednesday, Thursday.
I will bless the Lord.
On Friday, Sunday.
I will bless the Lord.
And all day, Sunday.
I will bless the Lord.
I will bless the Lord.
I will bless the Lord.
Bless his name.
I will bless the Lord.
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 He has done great things for me, so God will. He has done great things for me, so God will.
If you know God has been good to you.
He has done great things for me, so God will.
He has done.
He has done great things for me, so God
will. Come on, come on. He has done.
He has done great things for me. He has done great things for me. He has done great things for me.
Come on, somebody. Somebody about to get it. Somebody about to get it. Come on, come on, come on.
He has done great things for me. He has done great things for me. So I will.
Come on, come on. If you know he's been good.
He has done great things for me.
He has done so many great things for me.
He has done great things for me. He has done great things for me. He has done great things for me. He has done great things for me. So I will bless the Lord. Bless the Lord.
Yeah. Yeah, hallelujah. Come on.
Your sacrifice.
mean, I don't know about y'all, but I feel good about this thing. Because when I look back over my life, so many folks said she ain't gonna be nothing. But they were looking at my past. But I'm so glad that I serve a God that looks at my future. God said, I know what you will become. Is there anybody that say people threw you away? People talk about you. But God keeps taking you higher and higher and higher as long as you stay in him. So if God is that God to you, I want you to help me sing So Amazing. So
God. Come on, he's amazing. He's amazing. How do you know he's amazing? Because he saved you. I said he saved you in spite of yourself. Come on, see. Oh, so. Give him praise in the house. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My God. God is worthy to be praised. And guess what? My praise is not predicated on what the Supreme Court did or did not do. It ain't going to change my God. It ain't going to change my praise because he still inhabits the praises of his people. Watch this. Watch this. God is a spirit, and those that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. In other words, the Bible says that all have sinned. Y'all don't know when to shout, do you? It didn't say y'all have sinned. It said all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. So look at your neighbor and say, that's why you can't judge me and you can't judge my praise, because we're in the same boat. Oh, my God. Y'all don't know when to shout, do you? Look at the other neighbor and say, neighbor, you really can't judge me
You can't talk about me. You can't criticize me because we're all in the same boat. We were sinners saved by grace, and it's nobody but the Lord that has brought us saved.
All right. You can have your seat. You can have your seat. You can have your seat. Now, I want to say this. I'm not going to preach about what the Supreme Court did or they did not do. You're not going to hear that today because we need a word. All right? But I am going to say this. I am going to say this. It's amazing to me how we say we uphold the Constitution of the United States, and every senator and every politician takes the oath of office on the Bible. But then you negate the fact that it is the Word of God, and you do what you want to do. So I'm not upset about it because it ain't gonna change nothing I've been doing or nothing I've been preaching. I preach love, amen. But I will say this: I don't want y'all to get in no argument with folk and all this kind of stuff, because you got to be careful, because we all live in glass houses. Testing 1, 2, 3. Testing 1, 2, 3. We all live in glass houses, so we got to be careful. Why did I say that? Because let me help some of you all that are trying to judge the other side. Fornication is sin. But you got babies by different men. So you can't ostracize them. Look at yourself and understand that we all have some stuff that God is not pleased with. And that'll help you. That'll help you. And watch this. Love is what's going to conquer everything. Watch this. If we're going to be the church that God has called us to be, we got to love everybody. Those that we see their outward sins, because the person next to you tore up from the flow up too. You just can't see it. Okay. All right. That's my spiel on that. That's my spiel on that. Amen. God bless you. And if you have any questions, email me. I'll be glad. jcsrthompson@gmail.com. Listen, we are glad that you are here today. Our music ministry is off to a great start, and we thank God for what he's doing in our midst. Thank you, wonderful minstrels. Listen, there are a couple of things I want to say. I want to thank you for on last week. We did a marvelous job. I just want to thank the committee for all that you've done, the picnic and all. We just thank God for what he has done. With that being said, our media ministry, I don't know if you seen this or not, our media ministry, Brother David Moore, that heads our media, he pulled one over on everybody, and he did something without permission. And he usually does not do anything without permission. I usually know everything, but I didn't know this. And so I want to share this with you at this time. You ready, Dave? All right.
God is really blessing our ministry, and you never know how people are watching you. It messed me up. I didn't know David put that on Facebook, and the next morning about 6-ish, before I did the prayer call, I got a call from Bishop Walker, and I was scared to death. I didn't know what to say. And he said, did you get the video? I said, yes, sir. And he said, well, I want to meet with you Thursday night. I want to sit down, Bishop Morton and myself and you will sit down. We have some work for you to do. And the Bible is true. The Bible is true. You don't have to lick up behind nobody. And I keep telling folk, be who you are. Don't try to act like nobody else, be you. And so Bishop Morton and Bishop Walker, we will meet Thursday after the night service for the Bishop's Hour. I am excited. I am privileged. I don't know what they want me to do, but whatever they want me to do, I'm honored and privileged. I keep telling you, the Bible says, these signs shall follow them that believe. That means that you don't have to hunt blessings down. They'll find you. And so we thank God. I want to thank David, and he called, and it's amazing. Like I said, all he did was say the church name. They immediately knew who we were. That speaks volumes of the kind of ministry that we are portraying, that they are watching. Bishop Walker told me that, listen, I get home at night and I watch you on YouTube. I'm like, what? Are you serious? And so I just thank God for how he's using our ministry in a very positive way. And we thank God for each and every one of you. Just a few announcements. Of course, Wednesday night services, 6 p.m. prayer and youth fellowship, 6:30 Bible study. Sunday school, 11 a.m. Of course, we live stream for Bible study and Sunday school. If you need any information is available on our Facebook page and our website at obctuscaloosa.org. You can also give online at obctuscaloosa.org 24 hours a day. Our radio broadcast is every Sunday at 5 p.m. on three stations, 107.3 FM, 104.3 FM, and 1280 AM. Our daily prayer conference call is at 6:30, 7 days a week. Deacons and ministers training is over. Well, deacons training is over. And so I want these candidates to stand so you can give them a hand clap of praise. They have done very well. And we thank God for them. Brother Walker, stand. And some of them are not here. But here's what we'll do. On the second Sunday in July, we will not have communion the first Sunday. We will do it the second Sunday in July. We will loose these men and we will let them go. And I'm excited about what they are about to do and what God is about to do in their lives. Amen. And so we thank God for each and every one of them, because Deacon needs some help. We have a couple. I know Brother Jonah joined us from another ministry, and we are going to sanction him that Sunday. He's already working, and we thank God for him. All right, let us not forget, July 15th through the 17th is our international conference in New Orleans, and so we're excited about that. We got some information by email that Sister Rollins needs to share with all the parents. They are very sticklers about children. When we have children, because the place is so big, we are going to have some paperwork on file with them. Who are the chaperones? Who the children belong to? We don't want any children to get lost, okay? And so after service, we need to see her about some paperwork that we need to get done, all right? Our 21-day fast will be completed at 4 o'clock this evening. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. All right? Pray that I don't break in celebrations at 4 o'clock to give me a cupcake, but we thank God for all of you, all right? And the crew, our youth ministry, Christians Ready, Equipped, and Willing, have a quarter drive, and they kicked it off Wednesday night, and we thank you for those that gave our children's quarters, and they will be collected on Wednesday night during our youth fellowship. And we want you to pick a youth. we want you to pick a youth that attends our Wednesday night fellowship and give them some quarters, all right? The drive will end on Sunday, July 19th, all right? Sunday, July 19th, it will end. And I just want to let you know the Tots are in the lead, the 3 to 5 year olds, all right? Yeah, they ought to be in the lead much as we gave them, but all right. And so y'all got to catch up. I thought the teenagers were leading that, but the babies are leading, all right? Also, last but certainly not least, our youth ministry back to school bash lock in will be Friday, July 31st, and you'll hear more about that. And we know we need donations, school supplies, hygiene, cleaning supplies will be accepted on Wednesdays and Sundays until the 26th, all right? And so anybody wants to donate, please see one of our youth workers. Please, ma'am, please, sir, all right? Our gyms, girls mentoring group will meet briefly after worship in the hospitality suite, all right? Briefly after, that comes from Sister Erica. She's not here today, but she made sure that I had that announcement. I thought you weren't gonna be here today. Okay, all right, well, she is here. Well, I got it. There it is right there. All right, thank you so very much. I think that's all the announcements that I have. Listen, at this time, we're going to worship the Lord with our giving, and we can't beat God's giving no matter how hard we try, and our ushers and our officers will come to receive our tithe and our offering at this time. God loves a cheerful giver, amen? And so at this time, those of you who are prepared to give, we ask that you prepare your hearts and your mind to give. If you need to do it online, you can do that at this time if you need be so, all right? And Deacon Pruitt will come and lead us in our offertory prayer at this time.
Father God, we come once again and say thank you. Thank you for this moment. Thank you for enabling us, O merciful Father, to be obedient to your word. Father, we ask that you would bless it in the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Brother Deacon. At this time, we'll stand on my left and my right, and the usher will direct you around as you come to give a tithe and your offering. The music ministry will give us a ministry and music. All right, at this time, on my left and my right. I'd have forgot where I was.
Oh,
Prayer time, and we have so many things that we need to petition the throne of God for. I want Sister Sharon to come. You're going to the board tomorrow, right? You're going before the board tomorrow. We want you to come. Sister Terry, come stand with your mother. She's going before the transplant board tomorrow. And I want every woman to stand with her, and every woman in this room to get close to her. I want to say this. I want to say this for us as African American. I'm not saying this to be prejudiced. I'm not. This is just a fact. We really need to consider and really take a serious look at organ donation, because our folk are dying prematurely because there are not matches for us. 75% of African Americans are on the donor list. 75% of African Americans. But we donate less than 15%, right? And I want us to take a real serious look and really think about how we can save a life, how we can save a life after we gone, how we can save a life. If you lived a pretty good life and you had not abused your body 9 times out of 10, you can be an organ donor. Now, I'm not, they didn't pay me to say that. It's just that I talked to one of the physicians this week, and he just let me know the raw truth about why so many of them receive and so many of us don't. And so I want us to pray, especially for Sister Sharon, as she gets ready to go before the board tomorrow. pray that God does a miraculous thing, that they find a match. So that they find a match, not just any match, but a match that will match and fit and give her a better quality of life. Do you believe that God can do that? I believe he can do it. I believe he can do it. If the saints pray, I need every person pointing towards her, those that are near her, you can place your hand on her. I need every saint that's, we're just going to petition his throne. We're not going to be selfish. Whatever we got going on, it don't matter right now. Somebody needs a blessing from you, a miracle. He does miracles. He does miracles. He still can perform miracles. And so it's about her today. It's not about nobody else. Whatever you got going on, let's plead the blood of Jesus over her life. And then not only that, watch how the devil is crafty. Her son is being attacked. He had brain surgery some months ago and started having seizures last night. It's just the enemy trying to get them to doubt. But the devil is a liar. Everything gonna work out. Her health is gonna be better. Curtis is gonna be better. They're gonna have a testimony that say it is no secret what God can do. What he's done for others, he'll do for you. And so let's pray. Father, we love you. We praise you. We give your name glory. We give your name praise. Because there's no God like our God. God, we come this afternoon unselfishly. Every person in this room is praying with and for Sister Sharon. And so, God, we pray right now in the name of Jesus that while we are praying, you are moving on the altars of the Board of Transplant heart right now. And when she gets there tomorrow, they will scratch their heads and say, I don't know why we're doing this. I don't know why we're saying this. But it's because the saints pray today. And so, God, we pray right now in the name of Jesus that any doubt that's in Sister Sharon's heart, any doubt that's in her mind right now, that you remove it right now in the name of Jesus. If there are people that are around her that are talking negative, we ask that you close up her ears to hear positive things right now in the name of Jesus. It will happen. It will happen. And we believe that it will happen, God. And so we plead the blood of Jesus over her life. Touch her right now, God, from the crown of her head to the sole of her feet. Fix what is broken right now in the name of Jesus. We pray for her son, Curtis, right now. The devil is trying to attack him, but we plead the blood of Jesus over him. God, we pray right now that you fix his heart, fix his mind, whatever is going on. If he has doubt in his mind, we ask God that you remove it right now in the name of Jesus. God, this altar is surrounded by people that are praying with Sister Sharon. You said in your word that if we be in one place at one time, that you will show up. And so, God, right now, in the name of Jesus, we ask that you show yourself mighty right now. Heal, deliver, set free right now in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you for your power. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your mercy. You're doing it right now. And so, God, we pray the prayer of faith that it is so. I said that it is so. And we claim victory over her life right now in the name of Jesus. She shall live. I said she shall live.
she shall have what she needs. Everywhere she treads, she will be blessed. Going out and coming in, she will be blessed. And you will use this time as a testimony for what you can do if we earnestly call upon your name. And so we thank you. We thank you. We give you praise. These and many other blessings we ask in your darling son Jesus' name. The name of Jesus, that every knee shall bow. The name of Jesus, every tongue must confess. The name of Jesus, he's Elohim, he's El Shaddai, he's Jehovah Jireh, he's Jehovah Nissi, he's Jehovah Shalom, Jehovah Siskanu. God, we thank you for being our God. And we'll be careful to give your name glory and praise. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Now clap those hands like you got victory. Come on, clap those hands like you got victory. There's victory in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on, praise God. It's already done. It's already done. It's already done. Hallelujah. 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 Yes, God. Come on, praise God. Come on, praise God. Don't get tired. Let God have his way. Yes, Lord. Take life anymore.
Genesis 21. To the officers and members and all of you, my father's children, to those that are listening by radio, God bless you and keep you is our prayer. You are tuned in to our broadcast, and we are located at 1761 McFarland Boulevard, Tuscaloosa, 35406. Thank you so very much. Genesis 21, verse 9. Thank Deacon Elect, Grant read it in your hearing. I want to read it, just a few verses. Genesis 21, that's the first book of the Bible, just in case you were wondering where that was. Genesis 21, verse 9. Now, I do want to say that I pre-planned my sermons, and it just so happened because I didn't preach last Sunday. I had this plan for last Sunday, and it failed at a good time, right? And so Genesis 9, I'm reading from the New Living Translation. We'll read different from yours, but has the same meaning. But Sarah saw Ishmael, the son of Abraham, and her Egyptian servant Hagar, making fun of her son Isaac. So she turned to Abraham and demanded, "Get rid of that slave woman and her son. He is not going to share the inheritance with my son, Isaac. I won't have it." Verse 11, this upset Abraham very much because Ishmael was his son. But God told Abraham, "Do not be upset over the boy and your servant. Do whatever Sarah tells you, for Isaac is the son through whom your descendants will be counted." Verse 13, "But I will also make a nation of the descendants of Hagar's son, because he is your son too." Verse 14, "So Abraham got up early the next morning, prepared food and a container of water, and strapped them on Hagar's shoulder. Then he sent her away with their son, and she wandered aimlessly in the wilderness of Beersheba." Verse 15, "When the water was gone, she put the boy in the shade of a bush." Verse 16, "Then she went and sat down by herself about 100 yards away. I don't want to watch the boy die," she said, as she burst into tears.
Here's where I want to hang my hat. Verse 17, but God heard the boy crying, and the angel of God called to Hagar from heaven, Hagar, what's wrong? Do not be afraid. God has heard the boy crying as he lies there. Go to him and comfort him, for I will make a great nation from his descendants. Verse 19, then God opened Hagar's eyes, and she saw a well full of water. She quickly filled her water container and gave the boy a drink. Verse 20 says, and God was with the boy as he grew up in the wilderness. He became a skillful archer, and he settled in the wilderness of Paran. His mother arranged for him to marry a woman from the land of Egypt. I want to talk from those verses. Verse 17 says, but God heard the boy crying, and the angel of God called to Hagar from heaven and asked Hagar, what aileth thee? That's what I want to talk about. What aileth thee? My brothers and my sisters, we are living in some last and evil days, that what is right is not considered right anymore, and what is wrong is considered right. And I wanted to challenge us as I teach and preach this lesson to put into our minds that all of us in this room and under the sound of my voice have something wrong with us. Let me preach to this side because y'all ain't talking right here. I said all of us have something wrong with us. And I want to suggest to you that as long as you are on this earth, there will always be something wrong with you. You're not going to cross every T. You're not going to dot every I. There will be people that don't like you because of what your last name is, who your mama is, how you look, how many degrees you have. But the question today is not what's wrong with them, but what's wrong with you. Because the problem is we like to fix other folk instead of looking at what's wrong with us. I'm preaching better than y'all responding, because we all got to understand that we all in this room at least got one thing in our lives that God is not pleased with. And watch this, church folk are some of the most judgmental folk I ever met in my life. In other words, as long as you ain't in their clique or you ain't doing what they're doing, they gonna ostracize you. But soon as somebody in their circle do it, they want all kind of grace and mercy. Now watch this. If all of us have sinned and come short of the glory of God, let me put this in for free. Folks think they gonna, Jesus, the Lord gonna bust the sky open because of what they did the other day. If he ain't bust the sky open because of all the cussing and the drinking and the smoking and the homemonging and the adulterous stuff that you doing, he ain't gonna come back no time soon. Watch this. It's amazing to me that in our minds we have degrees to sin. I don't do that, but you're doing something. And today I want to know what's wrong with you. Because it's easy for you to look across the road and look at what somebody else is doing, but it's hard for you to get a mirror and take a look at yourself. I'm preaching better. I'm going to preach every bit of it. I ain't saying for applause, Drew. I'm preaching lit. I'm trying to help folk, because it's amazing to me how we can ostracize everybody else without looking in our own houses. Oh, my God. You want to talk about other folk children when your children messed up. You want to ostracize other folk marriages when your stuff tore up. Oh, my God. You want to talk about everybody else's siblings when your siblings are not. What's wrong with you? What's
What's wrong with us? I'm going to tell you what's wrong with us, because can I put this in for free? This ain't on my notes. I'm going to get to the text in a minute. But I just want to tell you that, watch this. Some of our problems are not far off. I know you don't want to think that people in your family, your siblings, or in some cases your spouse, I know you don't want to think that they are jealous. But sometimes, watch this, you can be in a house of folk, watch this, don't watch the people that don't applaud, watch the people that, no, everybody can have friends in their life when they are doing good. But watch the people in your life when you go through some valley experiences. Because, see, I don't need folk when I'm on top of the mountain. I need folk when I'm in the valley of life, not to believe what they heard, but to know my character. And understand, listen, unless I seen it, it didn't happen. I wonder, do I have about five folk in here that say, listen, I need some folk in my circle to not talk about me behind my back, but pray with me when I'm in the valley. Folk get on my nerves. You act like you ain't never stayed with a man. You act like you ain't never stayed with a woman. And now that you done got saved, you want to talk about folks sacking. Baby, you sacked before you got married. Want to talk about what folk got on? You went with other folk husbands, slept with other folk wives. Now you saved and filled with the Holy Ghost, and you done forgot. Listen, what's wrong with you? Let me get to the text. Let me get to the text. I don't want you to think I'm preaching. I'm not preaching the text. Watch this. Watch this. Watch this. Watch this. Abraham had some issues because he had been the father of the faithful, but even in Abraham's life, his family was in shambles. The context of Abraham, Sarah, and Hagar, and Ishmael, according to Genesis 16, this arrangement did nothing but cause trouble for Abraham. And Sarah, watch this, was jealous of Hagar. Not only was Sarah jealous of Hagar, but she was jealous of the baby too. Ooh, I'm preaching better than y'all responded. Listen, Hagar was jealous of Sarah because of her relationship with Abraham. Oh my God. Poor Abraham is caught in the middle of trying to please two women. That's why, men, it's very important for you to understand you can't handle the one woman you got. Don't add to your misery. Hell, it's hard enough to keep one satisfied. Watch this, watch this, watch this, watch this. In our text, though, things have basically come to a head. They got some problems in the family. It was all right until she had the baby. Oh, my God, there have been some of you under the sound of my voice. Your baby daddy, you know, he was a big ball and shot calling. So you got with him and you thought you were going to change him. And you said, well, I'll accept him and I'll accept the children until the children start coming around. And when the children start coming around, you start scratching your head saying, you don't know if you can take it. But can I tell some of you single ladies, if you accept him, you got to accept his baggage too. And watch this, any man that just wants you and don't want all of you, listen, he got to accept yours too. So this woman, she didn't act froggy with Abraham and tell him, I know that's your baby, but I don't want you to have nothing to do with it. What kind of woman would say that? Oh, man, there are some of you under the sound of my voice. Something is wrong with you, because even though, watch it, maybe he did step out on you or maybe she did step out on you, it's not the child's fault. Oh, my God. And there's no way, watch this, that I can love the children inside the house and not love the ones outside. Oh, I'm preaching better than y'all responded. That wasn't even on my notes. The Holy Ghost just dropped that in me. Somebody just
got there. But watch this, watch this, watch, watch this. Let me tell you what happened. This things came to a head, and here there's a civil war going on in Abraham's tent. He as a result, Hagar finds herself in a desperate situation in the midst of that terrible time. She has a powerful personal encounter with God. And out of Hagar's pain comes a ray of hope for all those who find themselves in the hand, in the hard, harsh places of life. I want you to see today that God can take your hopeless situation and turn it around for his glory. I want to focus in on this question that the Lord asks her in verse 17. What aileth thee? Number one. What's wrong with her? Number one, if you see verse 9 through 14, it was a time of harsh rejection. I want to tell you that there are times in your life that no matter how good you are, people will reject you. Your husband will reject you. Your wife will reject you. Your family will reject you. And watch this, but they'll try to shine in front of other folks. I'm preaching better than y'all responding. In other words, they'll talk to you while you're at church, but when you get home, they ain't gonna say nothing. Matter of fact, we got too many folk that's acting. Listen, look at somebody and tell them, be real. You ain't happily married every day. You ain't got it going on every day. You and your spouse have fusses and be real. Ooh, I'm gonna preach every bit of y'all ready? Put your seatbelt on. Put your seatbelt on, baby. Watch this, watch this. There are some times in your life that you are going to be rejected. Because watch this, there are some people in your life that really don't believe you are who you say you are, and you keep trying to justify, but I came to make an announcement to you. Don't worry about the opinion of people. Worry about the opinion of God, and you stay where God has commissioned you to be and do what he says to do. So number one, you're going to have some rejection. Watch this, watch this, watch this, watch this now. Because things had gotten tense in the tent for many years. And in this passage, Isaac is about 3. And Ishmael is about 17. And they are celebrating Isaac's maturity from a baby to a little boy. Then things come to a head during the feast. And Hagar faces a terrible time of rejection. What happened? Verse 9 to 10, Ishmael was mocking and making fun of Isaac at the festival. Ishmael saw all his hopes of inheritance dashed in Isaac, and he knew that Isaac was the son of promise and that he was just the son of the slave. In other words, he knew that his brother was the one that came from marriage, but the other brother was the one that came from slave. In other words, watch this. You got to be careful, because you got to be careful of making children feel like you love one more than you love the other. Watch this. I learned something this week. While I treat both of my children equal, I treat both of them equal, but they are not the same. Y'all missed it. Because JR, watch this, JR is sneaky. And John Michael is a pleaser. And so I have not had to whoop John Michael near as much as I have to whoop JR, simply because JR a sneak and do it. Then when you catch him, he won't say a word. John Michael, when you catch him in something, what he will do is bust out crying. They are equal, but I don't treat them the same, because what it takes for JR, it does not take for John Michael. In other words, what I'm trying to tell you is, when you got children in the house, whether you want to know it or not, some of them feel like you love some of the children or this better than you love the other. That's why it's always important that you have a one-on-one with your child to let them know that they are special in your house, that there is no big eyes and there are no little U's.
Now watch this. He knew that Isaac was the son of promise, and he knew that he was just a slave. So he is jealous of Isaac, and he acts out during the feast. So Sarah sees this, and what happened, she demands that Hagar and Isaac be sent away. Now, it was all right for a few years, but my granddaddy told me, listen, too many grown folk in one house, that ain't no good. He said, it's enough for a husband and a wife to get along. When you add a third party, you got something going on. Somebody hollered over there. But watch this. The reason for the rejection, I just told you, but watch the realities of this rejection. Now, Abraham loves both of his children. He's reluctant, but God tells him that, wait a minute, this is a part of his plan for Isaac and Ishmael. Can I put this in for free? That the hell that you're going through, the rejection that you are currently going through, is in the plan of God. It don't feel good. You feel like you're by yourself. You feel like don't nobody understand you. But you need to understand that you are right in the will of God, because God is going to get glory out of this. Watch this. Oh, we all know Abraham loved that boy, and he's forced to send away his oldest son. Not only is he forced to send his oldest son away, but the son's mother. It broke Abraham's heart to have to send them away, but he did it. We all know that life can be just like that at times. We are enjoying ourselves one moment, and the next we are on the bottom looking up, wondering, how in the world did I get down here? This life is filled with hard realities and heartbreaking moments. Sickness comes. People die. Relationships fall apart. Depression rears in its head. Difficulties arise. Troubles dog our steps. But this is the reality of life. Come here, Job. Job will tell you, I had my share of problem. John will tell you, I've had my share of problem. Some have been there, and some are there, and some are on their way. Oh, man, y'all don't know when to shout, do you? Let me say that one more time. Some of y'all have been there. Some of y'all are there now, and some of you are on your way. In other words, trouble comes to every home. And can I tell you something? You can do everything right and trouble will still come. Not only was it a
time of rejection, I got 8 minutes. But number two, it was a time of hopeless realities. Look at verse 15. There was some problems. The water ran out. Sun beat down. Hey, God. And she gave up. Life is like that at times. Sometimes the burdens are more than we can bear, but they are never more than he can bear. I want to tell you that his yoke is with you. In other words, what I like about the yoke of God is that he'll let us get so far out, and then he'll snatch us back. And let us know, listen, oh, boy, that's going too far. What I like about the Bible said that his yoke is easy. See, you got to make sure you hooked up to the right yoke. Man, I'm preaching better now. I'm going to close in a minute. Listen, you got to make sure that you hooked up to the right yoke, because some of you are in yokes that you want to get out of, but you can't get out of because, oh, my, I ain't going to say that. Okay, watch this. Watch this. Not only were there problems in verse 15, but watch this. In verse 16, there were pains. Hagar's heart was broken. She is sure that Ishmael is going to die. And she don't want to witness the death of her son. So she does what any mother would do under the sound of my voice. She leaves him under a bush. She goes off and she weeps. She finds herself in a situation that she couldn't fix and from which she could not escape. And most of us like to be in control of our lives. when we can't control it or fix it, we get desperate. Even sometimes going to the extremes. Anybody ever been there that life was happening to you so fast that you just couldn't handle it? That you didn't know whether you were going or whether you were coming. Anybody ever been there to say, listen, I'm trying to do right. I'm paying my tithes. I'm coming to Bible study. I'm coming to prayer meet. And then somebody going to get on Facebook with a fake page and dog me and my family. Anybody ever been there to say, listen, I've raised all of my children. Two of them are doing right, but one of them, I don't know. Well, anybody ever been there to say, I've tried to love like I should love, but they still. Here's the truth. Problems, watch this. And this helped me this week. Problems are going to come into our lives. When they do, most time they will come unwanted and unannounced. When they come, they will hurt us deeply at times. When they come, we must not delay, but we must run to the Lord. And he will hear us, and he will help us. And I want to tell you, when problems come, don't be surprised at who the devil uses. Y'all miss this year. I've been through some stuff in my life because of ministry, and I was surprised, Tanika, at how the devil used my own family. Testing 1, 2, 3. You ain't kidding to me, don't worry about it. That was a time of hidden resources. We got to understand that even in the time of trouble, when we don't know which way to go, run to God. Let me close with this. It was a time of hidden resources. What happened? While Hagar went through this time of trouble and tragedy, she was enveloped by some very precious hidden resource. She didn't realize it, but God was there. And he had just what they needed to see her through. She was so overcome by her grief, she could not see the resources that were right there before her eyes. Anybody ever been there? You crying about a situation, and God is saying, I'm right here. You worried about problems and circumstances, and God is saying, I'm right here. Where is he? He's in verse 17. She didn't know it. But God had been there the whole time. He won't leave you either. The psalmist said, if I go to hell, thou art there. Y'all didn't know that was in the scripture? Yeah, the psalmist said, if I go to hell, thou art there. If I fly to the uttermost part of the world, thou art there. God is everywhere. God was there when you were going through whatever you were going through. She didn't know it, but God had been there the whole time. Number two, watch this. And I see God's presence in verse 17a, but I see God's peace in verse 17b. He called her by name. You have been praying and the Lord called your name. Scare the living daylights out of you and say, listen, cut it out. Quit crying. Get up. Quit complaining, because there's something wrong with you. Watch this. He'll call you by name. How do you know he'll call you by name? Come here, Job. Job said, I was minding my own business. I wasn't bothering nobody, and the devil and God had a conversation, had a meet, and didn't even invite me to the meet. Job said, listen, God asked the devil, have you considered my servant Job? I wonder, do I have about 10 folk as I get ready to close in the building that will understand that the hell you're going through is not because of you did something wrong, but it's because God asked the devil, have you considered my servant? Because I know what she gonna do. I know what he's gonna do. He's not gonna bow down. He's gonna stay the course because he knows that I'm with him. Let me close with this. Not only do I see God's presence, God's peace, but I see God's promise. Watch this in verse 18. He may not make you a great nation, but here's the shouting part right here. He'll take care of you. I'm not concerned about filling up a 1,400-seat sanctuary. All I want the Lord to do is take care of us. Listen, he may not put us on TV. He may not make us anything in the fellowship, but all I want God to do is take care of me. Is there anybody here that say, listen, if God does not do another thing, all I want him to do is take care of me. Take care of my family. Take care of my children. Take care of my wife. Take care of my husband. Take care of my uncles. Take care of my... I'm done. I'm out of time, but I'm not out of message. Sit down. I'm out of time, but I'm not out of time. Let me say this. Watch the shouting part in verse 19. He made a promise, but watch his provision. He opened her eyes and showed her what had been right in front of her all along. The reason that you keep on complaining about your spouse is that you got people in your ear that's waiting on you to move. And they want to bring up all the negative qualities, but a real friend will say, don't he take care of you? Don't she keep the house clean? Well, all that other stuff does not matter. But I need to tell you, there are people in your life that want to take your spot. Don't be fooled. Don't be fooled. Everybody in your circle is not for you. Jesus had 12 disciples, and one of them was a devil. Y'all ain't ready. Y'all ain't ready. Robert, I ain't ready today. They really ain't ready. Y'all, some of y'all should have ran around the room because you've been wondering why you've been catching hell. God is saying, I'm about to elevate you, but your weight limit got to drop some. In other words, I'm trying to take you to the next level, but you got to leave some folk at the second. Anybody want to go up? I said, anybody want to go up? Well, you got to drop some weight off. Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor. I want to go higher. I want to go higher. I've been through too much. I've been talked about, been scandalized. I want to go higher, higher. Anybody here want to go higher, 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 higher? Anybody want to go higher? Say yeah, yeah. The door is open. The door is open for you. What aileth thee? What's wrong with you? What's wrong with us is we have forgotten how good God has been to us. You got to learn how to appreciate what you have instead of looking at the negative. You complain about your spouse. You complain about your loved ones. You ain't been the best person in your life. You ain't been the best daughter. You ain't been the best son. But God gave you grace. You ain't been perfect, but you want everybody else to be perfect. The door's open for you today. You come by letter, candidate baptism by Christian experience at the choir scene. The door is open for you. If you're away from home, you're in college, you're in school, this can be your church away from home. You need a Bible-believing, Bible-teaching church. The door is open. They're coming. They're coming. God bless you. Through the fire.
Through the fire.
And I've been.
And I've been.
Through the flood.
Through the flood.
I've been broken.
I've been
come on,
broken.
Praise God. Into peace.
Into
Seen lightning flash.
Seen lightning flash.
From above.
From above.
But through it all.
But through it all.
I remember. That he loved me.
That he loves me.
The door's still open for you.
I've gone
through the fire.
Through the fire.
And I've been.
And I've been.
Through the flood.
Through the flood.
I've been broken.
I've been
come on,
broken.
Come on, my brother. Into pieces.
Into pieces.
Seen lightning flash.
Lightning flash.
From above.
From above.
But through it all.
But through it all.
That he loves Jeff.
That he loves.
And he cares for Jeff so much.
And he cares.
And he'll never,
and he'll never.
Putting more on me.
Putting more on me.
Than I. Come on. Come on. Come on.
I said, yeah.
Putting more on me. The door's open.
Put more on me, man. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. wish I had a witness, somebody that tried my God. And you know that 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 he'll never put more on you. I know it may seem hard. It seems like you can't press your way through, yeah, yeah. But I dare you, I dare you, I dare you, I dare you. Cause I tried them for myself. I tried them when I thought I lost my mind. Friends gone and all my family gone. I will lay awake at night, tears streaming down my face. But then one night, I gave it to Jesus. Anybody ever gave it to Jesus? Yeah, yeah. Hallelujah.
Come on, mean it, mean it. Look at him and tell him, no matter what you're going through, he has lifted your burdens. He has taken your load. You don't have to worry about it anymore. He has it. His shoulders are large enough that he can handle everything. Come on, minister to somebody. Minister to somebody. Come on, tell him it's over. It's over. It's done. God has done it. He's done it. He's worked it out for your good. That burden you had is been lifted. Hallelujah. 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 About to go. There's a sweet, sweet spirit in this place, and I know that it's the presence of the Lord. There's a sweet expression
on his face, and I know that it's the presence of the Lord. Sweet Holy Spirit, sweet Heavenly Dove, stay right here with us, filling us with your love. And for these blessings, we lift our hearts with praise. Without a doubt, we know that we have been revived when we shall leave this place. Sweet Holy Spirit, sweet Heavenly Dove, stay right here with us, filling us with your love. And for these blessings, we lift our hearts with praise. Without a doubt, we know that we have been revived when we shall leave this place. Father, we love you. We praise you. We thank you for the visitation of your Holy Spirit. We thank you for every person that came up to give their life to you. We thank you that what has happened in this room today, none of us in this building can take the credit. That is because of your love and your grace and your mercy that you have rested on this place. And for that, we're grateful and we're thankful. Some came in broken, burdened down, confused and worried. But we thank you through your spirit and through the participation of worship that you have settled our accounts long ago. And we thank you for settling it long ago. Thank you, God, for being God. And besides you, there is no other. Now, as we leave, we pray that that same spirit will help us to go to our jobs and to our homes. We pray that that same spirit will saturate our hearts and our mind. And we'll be careful to give your name glory and praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Come on, clap those hands and give them praise. And very quickly, several have come. We have Ivy Cannon and Iris Cannon who are coming at Christmas. Amen. They've been coming to Bible study, and so we thank God for them. Amen. They're coming. Delicia Scales is coming under Christian Experience. Latanya Thompson Young is coming under Christian Experience. God bless you. Gabrielle Mayfield, Christian Experience. Javaris Spencer, Christian Experience. Constance Foster, Christian Experience. We give God praise for what he is doing in our midst. Amen, amen, amen. Listen, you can consider yourselves dismissed. Go in peace until we meet again. God bless you.